Before we start solving the cube, we need to understand some basics about the structure of the Rubik's cube. In this video, I'll help you become familiar with the different types of pieces on the cube. So we're going to start with the absolute basics, which is that there are six sides on a Rubik's cube. The standard colour scheme has the white side opposite the yellow side, the green side opposite the blue side, and the orange side opposite the red side. And the layout of these sides is fixed, as you'll see shortly. So these colour pairs will always be opposite one another when your cube is solved. If your cube has a slightly different colour scheme, don't worry. This won't make it any more difficult. But what I want you to do now is just check whether the colour scheme on your cube matches the one on mine. And if not, familiarise yourself with your cube's colour scheme. So know which colours are opposite one another and maybe write that down or just remember it. So most cubes will be just like this, have yellow opposite white, blue opposite green, and orange opposite red. So now that you're familiar with the colours of the Rubik's Cube, let us take a look at the different types of pieces on a Rubik's Cube, which is far, far more important. So there are 54 stickers on a Rubik's Cube, but it's important to be aware that we don't actually solve it one sticker at a time. That would be impossible. In fact, the cube is made up of three different types of pieces, and there are only 26 pieces in total on the puzzle. So allow me to disassemble the Rubik's Cube to show you this. The first type of pieces are the centerpieces, and there are six of those. These are the pieces that lie in the middle of each side of the cube. The centerpieces are fixed in relation to one another and denote the colour of the particular side of the cube. That is to say, if you have a scrambled Rubik's Cube and look at the location of, for example, the orange centerpiece, that is where the orange side will be once the cube is solved. Notice also, similar to what I described before, that the white centerpiece remains opposite the yellow centerpiece, and the same goes for the other colour pairings. So these centers don't move, and they can be thought of as already solved. The second type of pieces are the edge pieces, which have two stickers on them. So the centerpieces have one sticker on them, these edges have two stickers on them. And these are the pieces which lie directly between two centerpieces. So, when you solve an edge piece, the two colours on the edge piece will match up with the corresponding centerpieces of those colours. So, to test your knowledge so far, let's see if we can locate every edge piece on a solved Rubik's Cube. So at the top layer, there is one here, one here, one here, and one here. So there are four edge pieces in the top. In the middle, there is this piece, this piece, this piece, and this piece, so four in the middle. And on the bottom, there's one here, one here, one here, and one there. So there are 12 edge pieces on a Rubik's Cube. The final type of piece on a Rubik's Cube is the corner piece. And these pieces, as their name suggests, lie at the eight corners of the Rubik's Cube. Now, a corner piece, unlike an edge piece, has three stickers on it. And on a solved Rubik's Cube, there are eight corner pieces, which are located, as their name suggests, at every single corner of the Rubik's Cube. It is important to know that different types of pieces on the cube cannot be interchanged. So, for example, an edge piece cannot end up where a centre piece is located, nor can a corner piece take the place of an edge piece. It simply doesn't work. So, because our centres are fixed, this means that the problem of solving a Rubik's Cube can be distilled to simply correctly positioning these 20 pieces, 12 edge pieces and 8 corner pieces, which seems like a far less daunting task. So there you have it, now we just need to do it without cheating. Also note that from this point onwards, I'll be using a different cube to help me out with the tutorial. Basically, it has brighter stickers, so they're easier to see, and it turns a bit more smoothly. So don't worry if it looks different to yours with the circular center design. The function and the puzzle is still exactly the same.